بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We're doing the chapter of Hasad Envy, and this is mentioned regarding how a person do the Hasad or Envy, and this is a kind of ailment or a disease. A person go through this, what are the n number of reasons for going through this? So let me explain the meaning and detail. Hasad, whatever the name you have, you want to have it for yourself and you don't want the other person to have it, and that is a disease. And other person, you want to not to have the other person, and in fact you want it for yourself and you think you deserve it. And rush is allowed, but in fact it's a positive aspect. In the rush, a person wants good for the others too, and they want good for themselves too. It's like a healthy competition. But in hasad, a person have a negative feeling. They want to snatch away the things, and they want to have it for themselves. And there are certain reasons and things that is mentioned. It has a negative aspect, and it's a kind of a bad thing in your self. It is from by birth. Some of the incidents mentioned in Quran, like when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam al-Islam and asked Iblis to do the sajda, Iblis said, "I am ana khairun minhu, better than the other person," and he didn't do the sajda, frustration. And the other incident mentioned about Habil and Qabil, the first murder ever on earth because of the jealousy. And also we have learned in Suratul Yusuf, person is hasad with the own brother, and it's in the lineage. So there are different aspects. So what are the different reasons for it? First is called kibr. Kibr is takabbur, arrogance. Because of the arrogance, you think I am the one who deserves this and other person don't deserve it. And that because of the takabbur, you think that way. And the second thing is adawat. Adawat means enmity. And because of the enmity, you do certain things with certain people in order to belittle a person, and you get the hasad. And the third thing is uj. You think whatever the khair other person is getting, no, I should get it, not the other person should get it. And authority, leadership quality, in a negative manner, it's not appreciated. You are doing dictation, leadership. You are enforcing things on the others. Leadership quality is appreciated in Islam. But how a husband is a leader, how a father is a leader in the family. But what about the person who is doing the dictatorship, enforcing the things? That is not appreciated in the family. And the thing, hers is you want to have the greed. You want to have everything for yourself, not the other person. So you want everything. And masarat is you have a competitive kind of behavior, whether you are doing the same job or whether you are doing the same field, and you have that competition, or you are living in the same place and you have a certain kind of competition in a negative manner. Like, what if I want to have it and the other person shouldn't have it, whether in place or clothing, so on and so forth. It can be in education. And this level of hasad and enmity is that kind of, even the alim is doing hasad with alim. What kind of hasad is that? They want to have more, and that person shouldn't have. They should have zero knowledge. One should have the competitive knowledge, they are gaining knowledge, you should also gain knowledge. There's nothing wrong in that. What is wrong in that is that when you don't want other to have it and you want to have it, that's a negative thing. Levels of hasad are there, and it is such kind of disease. It will destroy you, and it has it will lead to kabira guna, major sins. And this loss, you will have the ailment of disease, and that ailment, heart disease. It's such kind of heart disease, it is affected to the whole body. You are spiritually not strong, you're mentally not strong because you have hasad. when you have hasad, how you can check yourself when others are having a nifa, are you happy or not? You should give the dua and you should be happy in their happiness. Are you appreciating others or not? When people are not appreciating others and they are not happy in their happiness, that is a kind of a negative connotation. And you know, when others having the nema and you are not appreciating and this continuous behavior, one day Allah will reveal in front of others how much you may be hiding it. It's a kind of ailment. One should avoid this, and this will lead to destruction in this and the hereafter. And in this, you know, what are the things you plan? Two people, they are planning a hasad or a envy upon the third person. Like for time being, they are getting together to destroy the third person. You understand? This is the meaning and detail of the hasad. Let's see the detail of it, inshallah. So hasad, envy. قال الله تعالى أم يحسدون الناس على ما آتاهم الله من فضل. Allah the Exalted says, or do they envy men, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his followers, for what Allah has given them to his bounty? So when Allah has given, how we can do the hasad? We can't envy, because it is the distribution of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is mentioned in Surah An-Nisa ayah number 54. The next ayah, Surah Al-Falaq, ayah number 5. And this ayah is like, وَمِنْ شَرِ حَاسِدٍ إِذَا حَسَدٍ. We learn from the following ayahs and the hadiths. We learn about hasad. But when we see the revelation of the three surahs, the last three surahs, Mawazatain and Mawazat, this is like a protection shield against hasad too. So one should recite three times after the fard prayer and also in the morning evening duas three times kul surahs, all the three kul surahs. وَقَالَ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى وَمِنْ شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ إِذَا حَسَدٍ. Allah the Exalted says, and from evil of the envier when he envies. And here the first hadith, hadith number 139. عَنْ حَبِي حُرَيْرَ أَنَّ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمْ قَالْ لا يجتمعان في قلب عبد الإيمان والحسد. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu narrated, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, two things cannot be together in the heart of a believer. What is that? Iman, faith, and the envy. You know, can a iman and the hasad be together? When a person is having iman, can he or she be jealous with the other person? As I told you, you can have the competition, healthy competition, but hasad is like you want to snatch away and you want to have it for yourself. That is not appreciated. You have to understand that. And the next we learn in hadith number 140, Abdullah bin Amr radiallahu anhu narrated, Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, was asked, who among men is best? He replied, everyone pure of the heart, truthful of the tongue. They inquire, truthful of the tongue, we know, but what is pure of the heart? He, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said, he who is pure and pious, there is neither sin in him, nor transgression, nor ill feeling, nor envy. So in this hadith, it's mentioned, who is the best of the best? So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied, who has the pure, clean heart. And the second person is the truthful tongue. So they inquire, truthful of tongue, we know. But what is the pure of the heart? He, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said, he who is pure and pious, there is neither sin in him, nor transgression, nor ill feeling, nor envy. These are the things mentioned. You know, a person who is righteous or a pious person, they don't have sin in their themselves. And they don't transgression. Transgression, like, you know, crossing the limits, hurting the people, hurting everyone, that's the transgression. When you do transgression, what will happen? And it will be bad for everyone, for yourself and others. Nor ill feelings. If a person having ill feeling, that is not appreciated. Like, except there is a reason. If somebody is doing shirk, you hate that shirk thing. Like, you know, adding deities to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You should, but not hating the person. You should make dua. I'm just giving an example. Ill feelings. Nor envy. Envy is like, you know, you are envying in such a manner Like you want to have that thing for yourself and you want to snatch away that thing from the other person. So let's see the wording of the hadith. And Abdullah bin Amarin qala qila li Rasulullahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ayyu an-nas afdal, who is the best of the best? Qala kullu makhmumil qalb, that their heart is, you know, makhmumil qalb, clean heart. Sudood is lisan. Sudood is lisan, you know, truthful person. Like, you know, Abu Bakr Siddiq, because he was a truthful. It is easy to identify truthful. Sudood is lisan. Sudood is lisan. But makhum il qalb, it's hard, isn't it? So, sudood is lisan, na'rifu. Fama makhum al qalb. They said, how we know how the person is clean-hearted person. Qal huwa taqiyu. He has the taqwa, fear of Allah. And naqiyu, and he has cleanliness. La isma fihi wa la bagha wa la ghilla wa la hasad. So Allah's Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, a person who is pure and clean-hearted is a righteous person. He don't do any sin. He don't do transgression, nor ill feelings, nor envy. That is the thing. So the next hadith here mentioned about, like, you know, what are the things one person do. So here in this, this hadith mentioned about, you know, how a person is clean heart and, you know, truthful person. But it has so much detail about it. A truthful person is easy to recognize. But the person who is, you know, fear of Allah, you can make out. It's not like, you know, doing salah on time and you are fasting. Mamlat, you know, how you deal with the people. It's like, you know, some people, it's easy to do the ibadah, but how you deal with the people. And also, what is the like, you know, transgression, how you are crossing the limit. Like for the sake of Allah, you do the things to please Allah. But what about the people to whom you deal with? Your own family should appreciate you, your friends and your community. Ill feelings. If you get ill feelings, what you should do? You should say, A'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajim, and you should clean your heart. It is like never-ending procedure. How we learn from the hadith, a person who was guaranteed of Jannah was a person who was daily cleaning his heart. So that's how we should clean our heart, especially if person has like hurtful feeling for somebody. Like it happens, it's a life, but you should forgive and forget for the sake of Allah. Of course, you have to be careful. You can't keep your hand in the pit to, like, you know, harm you again and again. Nor envy, never envy, because ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is Rabbul Alameen. He can give you whatever He wants. Allah loves to give. And ask Allah. Allah is Ghani. And but never say like, you know, I want this and the person shouldn't have. That is not appreciated. One should avoid such kind of things. So may Allah save us all from such kind of behavior and such kind of feeling. Because the person who would, they are destroying themselves. How we overcome with this hustle. Like, you know, in order to overcome, one should love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and should have the fear of Allah. What we learned in the previous hadiths, like they should have taqwa of Allah, fear of Allah. If you have fear of Allah and if you have like righteousness in yourself, and you should avoid sin. Avoiding sin, how you protect your good deeds. And you know, hasad, when you do hasad, your good deeds will be destroyed. It will be like a bond. Like you get burned yourself when you do the hasad, when you hate somebody and you are doing that negative thing in your heart. Actually, you are destroying yourself. In this world, you can escape, but in the akhirah, you can't escape because your habitat amal, your amal will be destroyed. And what is a protection shield? You know, always when you see the other things, appreciate them, mashallah. You know what Allah gives? We are nothing. Rabbul Alameen is Khalik, Malik, and Mudabbir. And also, one recite Suratul Falaq, Nas, and Ikhlas morning and evening, three times, especially after the first prayer and in the morning, evening, Azkar. Jazakallah khairan kaseera. Do subscribe the channel, please. Channel name is El Quran for All Bayan. Bayan are in English and Urdu.